In this module, we're talking about how to determine the rate law for a chemical reaction given some rate data, some kinetics. So in general, okay, if we have our, you know, generic chemical reaction where the, remember the small, lowercase letters are the coefficients and the capital letters or the symbols or the formulas for the compounds. AA plus BB plus CC goes to DD plus EE plus FF. If we want to find the form of the rate law for this reaction, what that means is, okay, we know that the rate is going to be equal to the concentration of each of the reactants raised to some power, X, Y, and Z. Notice X, Y, and Z are not necessarily, and many times they're not, the coefficients. They're different. They can be. Sometimes they're the same, sometimes they're different. Anyway, we need to find X, Y, and Z, and then we'll have the form of the rate law. So for example, let's look at this reaction here. The dissociation of dinitrogen pentoxide, this is dissolved in carbon tetrachloride, CCl4, to produce nitrogen dioxide, still in carbon tetrachloride, and oxygen gas. The reason that we look at this here, it makes it easy, is that because the oxygen is a gas, it's going to bubble out of solution and escape, meaning that there is no appreciable reverse reaction to worry about complicating the rate, the change in concentration of the dinitrogen pentoxide. So this is a graph of the change in of the concentration of dinitrogen pentoxide over time for this reaction here. And so for this reaction here, we have the rate is equal to the rate constant times the concentration of the reactant to some power x, which we want to find. And what we have, okay, we're going to use instantaneous rate data. We have the rate at 0.90 moles per liter, concentration of dinitrogen pentoxide, and somewhat later at 0.45, that's 0.45 moles per liter dinitrogen pentoxide. If you look at these numbers, you can see basically, you know, they're cut in half. So let's look at that. So we know the rate law looks like this. We're trying to find X. So looking at the instantaneous rate at those two points, we can say that the rate is equal to K, concentration of dinitrogen pentoxide. So the first one, we know the concentration, 0.90 moles per liter to the X. Second, 0.545 moles per liter. Whoops, there's no seconds in there, excuse me. Just moles per liter. All right, so, but, okay, so also we know what the rates are because we got the tangents to the curve and the slopes of the tangents. 5.4 times 10 to the 5 minus 4th moles per liter second, and 2.7 times 10 to the minus 4th moles per liter per second. So if we take the ratio of rate 1, rate at 0.90 moles per liter, over rate 2, plugging in here, okay, and get this. So we're going to reduce that. So 0.45 XX, 5.4, 2.7 minus 4th. So 0.9 K, so the K's cancel. Let me just say how that works. So K's cancel, they're gone. 0.9 over 0.45 is 2 to the X. 5.4 times 10 to the minus 4th over 2.7 times 10 to the minus 4th is 2. So it looks like this. Rate 1 over rate 2 equals 2 to the x, but it's also equal to 2. This 2 came from the ratio of the rates, 5.4 times 10 to the minus 4th over 2.7 times 10 to the minus 4th is 2. This came from the ratio of the rate laws, k, concentration of N2O5 to the x, you know, at 0.9 and over 0.45, we get 2 to the x. Well, here, the only way this equation is true is if x is equal to 1. Now we know X. We know the form of the rate law. It's just K, concentration of dinitrogen pentoxide to the first power. See, once we know that, we can use either one of those rates, either 2.7 or 5.4 times 10 to the minus 4th, rearrange this a little bit, and we can get the rate constant, K. So just do a little bit of algebra, solve for K, and you get the same result if you plug in 2.7 times 10 to the minus 4th over 0.45 moles per liter. And now we know, K, it's 6 for this reaction, these conditions, 6.0 times 10 to the minus 4th per second, seconds minus 1. There we go.